Hello everyone, it's Sarah from Spicy Pinecone, and today I'm going to be making a tutorial video on how I make my labels. Now, this is probably the most requested video that I've ever gotten. I've had tons of questions. How do you design your labels? And how do you make them? Do you cut them yourself? And yes, I design, cut, and print all of my labels myself. I use something called a Silhouette Cameo. It's an electronic cutting machine. There's another type of electronic cutting machine called a Cricut, but I don't know how to use that one. I've heard it's pretty similar, but this is just for the Cameo. For those of you who don't know what a Silhouette Cameo is, you can find them on Amazon, you can find them on Overstock. Sometimes they have them on sale around Christmas time. I've found that if you get the starter bundle, it's a much better deal. You don't just get the machine, but you get the cutting mat, some replacement blades, and all kinds of other goodies with it too. It also comes with, you can see right there, that's the machine. But it also comes with the Silhouette Studio software. That is the regular edition of the Silhouette Studio software, and it is perfectly fine to use for labels. I never had a problem with it. I did upgrade to the designer edition. You can see up here, I'm going to be working in the designer edition, but it's just got a few extra features and everything, but it's not necessary. Pretty much anything that you can do in your regular edition, or your designer edition, you can also do in your regular edition too. Okay, so with that said, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to open your software, and I've already done that. Then you have to come over and you come to your page settings window and you click on that. And right now we have a 12 by 12 inch project. Now, some people have printers that are capable of printing a 12 by 12 inch surface area. My printer is not capable of doing that, and most printers aren't. So unless you have a specialty printer, you're going to want to change your surface area. And the way that you do that is in your page settings, you come down here, and it's automatically set to the 12 by 12. You're just going to switch that to current printer, which brings it to an 8.5 by 11 inch regular piece of paper. Now, when you are doing your project, also keep your medium in mind. If you are using printer paper or 8.5 by 11 cardstock, you're going to want to make sure that your project size reflects that. Now, since I'm going to be cutting on just a regular piece of cardstock that's 8.5 by 11, this project size is good for me. You can also cut on, like I said, sticker paper, vinyl, whatever you decide. But for now, we're just going to be sticking with a regular cardstock label. Now that you have your project size down, you're going to want to add registration marks. Now, registration marks, you find them up in this little window right here, and select them for the size that you have. Now, I have the Type 1 Cameo, and there's also a Type 2 in here, but it really, you're going to want to check your machine, and the larger machines, like the Cameo, are going to use Type 1, so just click that. And you'll see that on your project, now you have a little mark right here and over here and also down in the bottom corner. Anything in the gray area, you don't want to put any of your label into, because that gray area, it starts messing with your project later when you're trying to get a nice clean cut. So stay out of the little hatch marked area when you're designing your labels. Okay, now it's time to design your labels, and there are a million different things that you can do. You can go into the Silhouette library right here, and they have a lot of designs that you have to pay for them. Some of them are free, but most of the designs you have to pay for. I just prefer to make my own. So with this one, we're just going to say that we are going to make a cigar band label, which a lot of people like to use that. It's a very popular label in soaps. So you select the rectangle tool and you're going to draw out your rectangle. Okay, now one thing that you're going to want to keep in mind when you are designing your labels is how big around your soap is. So go ahead, measure your soap, And then make sure that you also include some overlap into your measurement. I just figured an inch. My soap all the way around was 8 inches, and I added another inch just to give it a little bit of overlap. And you can always trim the edges down later. Now, one thing you're going to want to keep in mind when you are designing in Silhouette is that the measurements in Silhouette are not always the measurements that you are going to find in the real world. I found that 8 inches in Silhouette sometimes is 7 3/4 in reality. So you will want to make a test label first. Okay, so for my soap, I measured it as 8 inches around, and I wanted my cigar band to be 1.5 inches thick. So I'm going to select the rectangle, and I'm going to scale it down to the measurements that I had figured out before. So I'll have 1.5 inches wide. By 9. Okay, so now my measurement is 1.5 by 9. And you can see if you click lock aspect and you change a measurement in one area and then hit enter, it'll also change it in another area. So since I wanted 1.5, I'm going to have to unlock it and then click 9. Hit enter and apply. And now you can see that it's 9 by 1.5 inches. So there is my cigar band template for right now. To deselect, you just move off of the figure and click anywhere on the screen. Now, say that you don't want just a plain rectangle. If you want to add some interest, there are other shapes that you can add to it. There are so many different options to choose. I'm going to try to keep it simple, though. So we'll take a circle. Okay, just going to make it 2.5 about. And you can always change it in the scale if it's not. See how that's not a perfect circle? We want a perfect circle because I've got just a touch of OCD. Click apply, and you'll see that it applies a transformation to the selected item. Okay. So we'll just put that as a rough, roughly in the middle. If you hold down the shift key and then click the other thing, now they're both selected. I want the circle to be smack dab in the middle of my template for my label. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to my align feature and click center. Now you can switch your alignment and play around however you want. You can do align left, align right, you can align it at the top, you can align it at the bottom, but we're just going to keep it dead center. Okay, now still with those selected, I have a Mac, so I would hit Control and then Weld. And watch, when you hit Weld, it'll stick those two things together, and now you have your cigar band with a nice little rounded area for your label information. Okay, so now that we have our template that we're happy with, we are going to start adding our label information to the inside circle right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the circle, and the reason that I'm doing this is I want our text to be curved. And you guys don't have to do this step, but it's just, I figured it would add a little bit of interest to it. Okay, so there's our inner circle. And you'll see why I put this circle over here in a minute. Now, we want to add the name of our business, which is going to be Bubblemeister. And frankly, that's just a name that, yeah, it just popped up into my head. But you can customize this any way that you want. Okay, go through and kind of play with different texts. Okay, that looks pretty good. You can change the font size. There's all kinds of different ways to customize it. You can do the spacing. You can see you can make it big and fat. You can make them all smushed together. That looks pretty good. Okay. Now, to have curved text, what you're going to do is with this selected, and look, if you accidentally, you know, have it deselected, you can just double click it and you'll be right where it's selected, and you can also edit it from here. You're going to grab this little circle down here. Now this little circle is going to allow it to lock on to the circle that you drew before, and it will curve the text for you. So I want this kind of curved around this circle. And that looks good right there. Okay, so we have Bubblemeister, and then I want more text. And highlight it, go up to fill, change it to black. Now you can see around it that it has red. And I don't want a red line. You can change the line colors to whatever you want. If you wanted like pink, and then this is the line thickness. You can also change the style if you wanted dotted. And so you can change, whoop, there's your thickness. But for this one, I don't want any color. I just want it to be black. Another thing about when you're designing your text, you can either do it over here, or if you wanted to have, if you kind of just wanted to eyeball it, I do a lot of eyeballing, you just click it once, and you can increase it like that. And you can see that it changes it over here. Well, we know we don't want it that big. Maybe about like, nah, it's even that's big. Okay. Now, you can leave this and this can be flat, but I want to snap it to the circle. I don't want it to snap to the outside. I want it on the inside. Okay. Now to me that looks pretty good. So we are going to select it. Okay, so after you've selected it, then you can rotate it. And fit it onto there. And of course, there are a whole bunch of other things that you can do too. You're going to have your ingredients. Center it, change the fill color, line color. But this is more of a something that you're just going to have to get into the program and kind of play with and learn. And the more that you play with it, the more you're going to find that you can make with it. Okay, now that you have some information on your label, you may want to customize it with something like a picture. So you come up to File, go to Merge. If you click Open, it would open up a new tab in a completely different project, and you would have to copy and paste it from that project into the project that you're currently working on. To make it easy, just click Merge, and then go down and select the file that you want to add. So this is our awesome soap bar picture. We're going to rotate that around. On an angle. Okay. And I'm pretty happy with that angle. But now this is hidden. So you can bring it up to the front. By doing that. So now we have our Bubblemeister soap company with our awesome soap, a whole lot of love ingredients, and now we are ready to print and cut. Now the way that you print and cut, you want to make sure that your label paper or cardstock, whatever you're cutting on, is in the printer already. You come up to File and then click Print. Print out your label.